Good evening, everyone. So my name is Rama Thakur. I come from a very small village in Manali, Himachal Pradesh. I'm going to start my presentation with just 3 slides. I won't bore you. I will try to make it as crisp as possible. Yes, we all had our challenges, like all the Everesters over here have been telling. आप लोग जो पीछे बैठे हैं, maybe आप लोगों में से कोई मुझे एक आधा जवाब दे सकते हैं. क्या आप लोगों में से कोई जानता है इस बार नेपाल गवर्नमेंट ने कितने लोगों को परमिट दिया था? Among the 4 who climbed this year, उनको छोड़ के कोई भी और आंसर दे सकते हैं कितने लोगों को परमिट मिला था? 433. And out of them, how many submitted? How many reached the top? 4 आप लोगों के साथ आज है, बाकी और कितने लोगों ने सबमिट किया? Any guesses? 167. That's just 38% of it, which speaks volume about this particular peak, of which when I was a mountaineering instructor at Avimas, we used to loosely talk about it. And usually when we would talk about it, we would say, yaar, paisa hoga to kal chale jayenge. But then one needs to realize, paisa hoga to nahi. Jaoge, isliye paisa aayega. I come from a background where I have a lot of debts already. I come from a background where my parents were earning, even till last 5 years, they were earning 5,000 collectively. And I still was able to summit Everest. I believe any one of us can do it. Right? But that zest, that zeal has to be there, and why you would like to climb it should be there. So my 3 ways to cover my journey is going to be, I would call it, climbing Everest is something that we call extreme leadership. In the terms of William Black, he says, great things are done when mountains and men and mountains meet. I totally agree with him here. However, in literal sense, mountaineering has been for very long time a male-dominated society, where, of course, female have their own, you know, setbacks or challenges, one of which being I have been working in this industry since the last 18 years. It took me 18 years to climb Everest. And one of them was that I was working with 40 to 50 gentlemen, being the only lady in the institute. So coming from there, of course, education is something that is very important for a person to climb Everest. What are the essentials now, if we speak about the essentials for climbing Mount Everest? One is the higher purpose. So I am a leadership trainer as well. So I believe in getting, understanding ourselves better, ki hum is duniya pe hai kyun? अपने लिए तो जानवर भी जीता है, राइट? हमारी कॉग्निटिव एबिलिटीज जानवर से बढ़ के है. इफ इट इज बियॉन्ड इट, व्हाट इज इट दैट आई एम सपोज टू डू? सो आफ्टर गोइंग थ्रू अ लॉट ऑफ सेशंस ऑन गोल सेटिंग एंड फाइंडिंग माय हायर पर्पस एंड विजन, आई वाज एबल टू फिगर आउट दैट आई एम नॉट ओके विथ वुमेन लिविंग दिस फील्ड, स्पेशली एज अ ट्रेनर, देम लिविंग दिस फील्ड फीलिंग होपलेस. So for them to provide hopes for everyone who come from my community, to speak for them and to showcase that we can also do it, and that what it takes, we have all of it. The only thing is we need to take that one step. For that, that was my higher purpose. For that, I manifested climbing Everest. But the second one is visualize your future. You need to see where do you want to see yourself in the next 20 years or 30 years. I would definitely say this, log bolte hain ki life choti hai, isko khul ke jiyo. In my experience of 37 years, life choti nahi hai. Life is choti when you get things easily. Life is very tough and it becomes tougher with all the decisions that we take in our life. So please live your life with ethics, values, build your character, so that your life is much more easier in terms of the years that you'd live on this planet. Third one is take ownership. You will have to take ownership for your future. It's not your parents, it's not your husband, it's not your grandparents or any other third person who will build this future for you. So this future has to be built by ourselves for us. If we don't take those bold steps which are required towards attaining our goal, it will never be achieved. Coming from there, 18 years, I have worked with a corporate company for 4 years. Right now, I'm working in Bangalore in an international school, IB school, which is over there I'm working as a leadership trainer, which has given me immense opportunities to not only grow in terms of my cognitive abilities, but also in terms of providing me opportunities to climb my different Everest at different stages of me being over there. One being, of course, Kilimanjaro. Otherwise, I would have never stepped out of my country to go out. Right now, I have been traveling different countries, and I have almost covered like 10 countries, but I haven't paid for it. I'm thankful to the education that I got, and I'm thankful to the organization that, yes, they were able to provide me with that facility. However, Everest was all on my own. Now, the next one is the power of continuity. As a leader, I believe all of us sitting here, hum log jitne log bhi yahan baithe hain, hum sab leaders hain. Sirf apne aap ko pehchanne ki zarurat hai ki aapki leadership skills kahan rehti hai. Right? Agar aap mein wo leadership skills hai, agar aap usko pehchan jaoge, to uske aage aapko sirf ek cheez ki zarurat hai, and that is persistency, as sir was saying, and I would call it continuity. आप एक चीज करोगे, लाइक आई वॉज डूइंग क्राउड फंडिंग, अनलाइक आर फ्रेंड ओवर हियर, आई वॉज वेरी अनलकी इन इट, आई गॉट 60,000, लकी इनफ 60,000 तो मिला एटलीस्ट. देर यूज टू बी डेज वेन आई यूज टू गेट 40 रुपीज, एंड आई यूज टू बी वेरी हैप्पी अबाउट इट, किसी को मेरे ऊपर विश्वास हो रहा है, 40 रुपए दे रहे हैं. दे यूज टू बी टाइम्स वेन आई यूज टू गेट लाइक 10,000 और 15,000, एंड आई यूज टू बी थ्रिल्ड अबाउट इट, आई यूज टू फ्लॉन्ट अबाउट इट, आई यूज टू टेल पीपल कि सी someone is believing in me, and that's all the difference that, you know, empowering yourself through a higher purpose brings to the community. It brings you together. Though I believe my penetration into the society might not have been as much as I wanted the message to go out, but I'm still going to work on it. So these were the four essentials, as I would call it, which were very important before climbing Everest. Now, while I was climbing Everest, since I am at a particular age, and since I had financial issues, the entire time before climbing Everest, I was looking only into the financial aspects of it, and I wasn't able to give that much of a time for my physical endurance to build that. The only time that I could give that time for that was like an hour or half an hour in the morning, because of which I had health issues, starting from I got dysentery as soon as I reached the base camp, to getting the khumbu curve just before the final summit. My entire ribs were paining. Itna dard kar raha tha ki mujhe lag raha tha ki mere ribs toot gaye hain. Aante jo, I don't know what it is called in Hindi, but ribs. Waise toota hua dard ho raha tha. Bag mein piche sab jagah, matlab itna stress pad gaya tha ki har ek kadam bahut mushkil lag raha tha chalna. But jab aap Everest pe jaate ho aur piche mudne ka sochte ho, there is one more thing that comes along with it. How many people are you letting down? Including yourself, which is the most important one. And even if that is the case, I knew I won't die, but at the same case, I was like, am I giving my 100%? If I'm not giving my 100%, I don't have the right to say that I should be turning back. So, jaddojahed chalti hai, 4 din bina khana khaye bhi rehna padta hai, bina pani piye rehna padta hai, but agar aapka will, determination strong ho, to definitely aap top tak pahunchte ho. ठीक है, lack of right equipment is one of the biggest issue in India, because definitely we don't get the equipment here, as all the mountaineers would agree with me. We have to bring it from outside. And the next one is physical and health. I've already spoken about finance. I've spoken about. So I'm going to dig directly into my takeaways from Everest. Everest for me was only possible. मैं तभी कर पाई because उसके पीछे एक reason जुड़ा था. मैं एक माउंटेनियर हूँ, मैं लोगों को क्लाइंबिंग करने के लिए लेके जाती हूँ. इस बार मैं किसी और के अंडर क्लाइंबिंग के लिए जा रही थी 18 साल बाद. अनलर्निंग एंड रीलर्निंग वाज अ डिफिकल्ट प्रोसेस फॉर मी, कमिंग ऑल द वे टिल 18 इयर्स. अब अपने तरीके को भूलना और नेपाल के तरीके को अपनाना वॉज लिटिल टफ, बट येस विद अ विजन एंड अ पर्पज इट वॉज एंटायरली पॉसिबल. सो दैट्स I have already told what my vision and purpose was, to inspire women guides, instructors to continue their career in the outdoor field even after the 30s. I'm going to continue doing this, and I would request all of you to please do pitch in your own ways how we can motivate them. The next one is mental robustness. So when you are going through tough situations, it's not the body, इट इज अ माइंड. आप दिमाग से कैसा सोचते हो, दिमाग से कितने स्ट्रांग हो, उसी के कारण इधर आप क्लाइम करोगे या तो आप क्लाइम नहीं करोगे. एंड यस ऑफ कोर्स विथ एज ये फैक्टर बढ़ता जाता है कि हमें थोड़ा डर ज़्यादा लगता जाता है टू टेक एनी काइंड ऑफ न्यू चैलेंजेस, राइट. बट देयर इज ऑलवेज इफ देयर इज अ विल देयर इज अ वे, राइट. एंड दिस आई एम ऑल्सो स्पीकिंग अबाउट व्हेन आई से मेंटल टफनेस, आई एम ऑल्सो स्पीकिंग अबाउट ओवर हियर अबाउट सीइंग डेथ्स राइट इन फ्रंट ऑफ यू. पीपल लोग आपके सामने सामने गिर जाते हैं. लाइक मेरे सामने लोग गिरे, मेरे सामने जैसे ही मैं उस जगह पे पहुंचने वाली थी एक यंग शेरपा, लाइक 5 मिनट पहले उसने अपनी जान गंवाई. तो मेरे लिए मैं डेड बॉडी पहली बार देख रही थी. इंडिया में माउंटेनियरिंग इज़ क्वाइट सेफ एज कम्पेयर टू एवरेस्ट ऑफ कोर्स, एंड उतनी डेड बॉडीज की आदत नहीं होती है. तो मैं इमोशनली पूरी ड्रेन हो चुकी थी. बट इस ऐसी सिचुएशन में भी योर विजन योर पर्पस इज स्टिल एट स्टेक. तो कहीं ना कहीं अपने आप में हिम्मत जुटानी पड़ती है और फिर से वापस पैर पे खड़े होके चलना पड़ता है. दैट हैपन्स ओनली व्हेन यू आर मेंटली टफ एंड रोबस्ट. एंड द लास्ट वन इज नेटवर्किंग, आई वुड कॉल इट अदरवाइज बिल्डिंग रिलेशनशिप्स. सो मेरे लिए एवरेस्ट पे बिल्डिंग रिलेशनशिप्स हैड डन वंडर्स. लाइक ऐसा आई थिंक कामाख्या का अकेला कैंप था, आई वॉज टेलिंग हर, जिसमें मैंने जाके बात ना की हो. अदरवाइज मैं हर एक कैंप में जाती थी, मैं बात करती थी, सबके बारे में जान पहचान रखती थी, उनके वेयर अबाउट्स, उनके प्लान्स, डिसीजंस एंड ऑल, आई यूज्ड टू टॉक अबाउट इट. बिकॉज ऑफ विच व्हेन आई सबमिटेड एवरेस्ट आई डिड नॉट गेट एनी काइंड ऑफ ट्रैफिक ऑल द वे फ्रॉम बेस कैंप टिल द टॉप एंड बैक. एंड आई क्लाइम्ड एवरेस्ट व्हेन द वेदर वॉज सो गुड दैट द विंड कंडीशन वॉज 10 km/h. ऑल दिस हैपेंड जस्ट बिकॉज ऑफ नेटवर्किंग एंड बिल्डिंग रिलेशनशिप्स. Now, along with this, that would be it. Along with this, I'll just show you a glimpse of my Everest journey through a video. So I'm not in the video. Please do not search me there because you're seeing it through my eyes. Video, please. Yeah, so one is our middle one is while climbing up, the other two are while I was coming down. These were the only times when my Sherpa was around me and he clicked pictures. I had a lovely Sherpa, his name is Mingma again. Quite a few of them have Mingma name. He was a smoker. So chain smoker, he would stay like 20 feet away from me. Always smoking but making sure that I am safe. Ladies and gentlemen, this is 23rd of May, 4:30 a.m. I was able to hoist the flag of India on top of Everest, and this was a proud moment for me. Thank you.